لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، ما لنا رب سوى.
لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا ونبينا محمد بن عبد الله الصادق الأمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله سيد الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين. أحمدك ربي على كل قضائك وجميع قدرك، حمد الرضا بحكمك لليقين بحكمتك، وأصلي وأسلم على خير خلقك ونور عرشك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على أشرف الخلق وحبيب الحق المصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Respected brothers and sisters, viewers, dear friends, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ahlan wa sahlan, welcome to our program. First of all, I'd like to thank my cameraman, Brother Yusuf and Brother Imtiaz and all our friends behind the camera, and shukran jazilan for their help. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala use our ITV as a call of Islam, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward all our brothers who are watching our program and supporting our ITV, inshallah. Once again, we thank all our viewers, all our friends from Johannesburg, out of South Africa. Shukran jazilan. I'm waiting for your emails and SMSs. Let me start with the first request from the brothers talking about the miswak. Now, the Sunnah al-Nabi, I did talk before about Sunnah al-Nabi. Before, we do trust Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and his action without even explanation. Definitely, his action, it's from Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Miswak, or the toothbrush which the Muslim use it, people, they say they're eating sticks. I said, no, we are practicing the Sunnah to Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And we trust our beloved Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Ask doctors, scientists, how much benefit come to the person who is using that miswak or that brush which the Muslim use it. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith, لولا أن أشق على أمتي لأمرتهم بالسواك عند كل صلاة. If I don't put a burden on the shoulder of my ummah, I should have asked them, command them to use the miswak in every salah. Before every salah, it means five times a day. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put his secret in the action of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you ask the doctors. He said, تَسَوَّكُوا فَإِنَّ السِّوَاكَ. Use the miswak, that shajaratul araq, piece of the shajaratul araq, مَطْهَرَةٌ لِلْفَمْ. That cleanness to your mouth. Definitely is purification to your mouth. And now they say the mouth is the entrance of all the viruses and diseases. And then he said, مَرْضَاتٌ لِلْرَبِّ, which is a Muslim always use that. We also think about cleanness, but we also think about pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَرْضَاتٌ لِلْرَبِّ, because we please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We trust our beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَا جَاءَنِي جِبْرِيلُ إِلَّا أَوْصَانِي بِالسِّوَاكِ. Is no time I met angel Jibreel without asking me to use and to ask my ummah to use the miswak. So you know how many times for 23 years Jibreel alayhi salam came to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, every meeting miswak, miswak. So it's not a joke, it's not extra thing, it's very important. And he said, حَتَّى لَقَدْ خَشِيتُ أَن تُفْرَضَ عَلَيْهِ. So I was, he said, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I was so worried that it could be a must upon me, that miswak. وعلى أمتي, and upon my ummah. So we have to highlight the importance of miswak. Number one, مرضاتُ للرب. And ask doctors where our disease come on the food, and ask dentist what is the problem of sickness, and say the stomach is the place or residence of all the sickness, and also the entrance of the stomach is our mouth. That's why We do trust Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we understand that is a hikmat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have to encourage our sisters and brothers to use the miswak is mardatun lirrab, to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our regular question regarding the music, I don't know why my friend always sending that question to me, and I said to him many times, I'm not the great mufti so that people will follow and all that. We just advise here, and we try to say something which can lead the people to do good. We drink coffee and tea, and someone said, no, I want the food mild, hot, salt and pepper. Try to adjust taste, water, smelling and all that. Food, we don't have same, adjustment. This man like oily food, this one like a braai one, this one like a vegetarian food, this one like meat, this one like chicken. Not only that, even in the chicken itself, someone like wings, someone like that. So for food, we got different opinion and different needs, and we try to adjust. That is called the food of the body, or the food of nourishing our body. Sometimes that food sounds very tasty, but it kills also. It kills. Many people say, oh, alcohol is very lovely, keeps you high. But you see how many problems when you have alcohol. Someone, he say drugs keep you up. But is it legal? So we have a desire of sexual desire. So how many people get infected by it because they misuse that desire and all that? Some people say pig is good to eat and see how many problems and all like that. So not everything nice, it means good or beneficial. Because you sometimes take away food, the children eat and see how many problems they have. The sickness in the animal is more than the human being, less than a human being. Because we try to enjoy. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Nahnu qawmun la na'kulu hatta najua, wa idha akalna la nashba." We're just a nation, we eat only when we are hungry. And when we eat, we don't get full. To get hungry again and to adjust it. Now we'll come to the music now. You have body, and we have ruh, soul, and we have nafs. Nafs is that desire, that invisible inner in yourself. Many people, they mix between ruh and nafs, they don't separate them. And plenty of ulama said, no, nafs is something, ruh is something else. Number one, you are sleeping. So you have ruh and body. When you wake up and you see the food there, now you have ruh and body and desire. So you got three things in yourself. And our ulama, they put it very clear. That light in front of me here is three pieces. Power, that electricity run on the cable, and we have a globe, and we have light. So three things there. Light cannot come without that globe there, that new light. And that new light there will never work till you get power that from the station there. So three of them are important for that light. So how are you going to adjust? You have ruh, you have nafs, you have body. Body, we got food, but not any food you eat. Allah adjusts it also. But some other food is not halal but tasty, but we don't eat. We also drink. So you cannot leave yourself for your nafs just to follow. Even the animal, they don't eat any food. They eat, they're the one which Allah gave it to them. Right. Sexual desire as well. Now we're having music, and we have Quran, we have dhikr, we have songs, we have dancing, we have all that entertainment. Many of our friends, especially young boys and girls, they say, it sounds very nice. It's a food of soul. They say, no, wait. Yeah, is it halal food or haram food? Before we argue, we remember the alcohol and juice. Remember the meat of the chicken and meat of the cat, even if it tastes good. Because we have command of Allah. How to adjust that desire? So now many of our brothers, they say, no, music keep you what is it? I say, no, we have, you adjust your mood, you adjust your ruh and your soul and your body with the wrong medicine. No, but I feel good. They say, yeah, but even those who are drinking, they feel good. Not everything good. You follow. Because we have alternative and we know how to adjust that need of the soul or that desire of the soul. Okay. If the music food of the soul, so a Quran food of what? Like this. Now I'm asking my young. All right. You're listening to the music from morning till afternoon. How many reward you get? That's why Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when he passed and he heard that music, he did not reject it. He just practically, with action, he put his two fingers right in his ears. But Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala did excuse those who yasma, those who hearing the music. As I said before, I'm sitting on a taxi, and I'm the only Muslim, and then that taxi driver, we got 12 passengers or whatever, and he put the CD there, and the music goes on. I'm unable to stop him, so I'm listening now. Or I'm in a shop or shopping center or in a town, or my next door, whatever. Now I'm not listening, I'm hearing that. That's why every part of your body got lead cover, except the ears. We don't have that lead. Because Allah knows that you're going to meet something like that. Right. This another thing is called yastami'a, listening. Listening, not hearing, listening. You go to the shop or you tune the station, you repeat again, you download it, you put it there, that one I'm talking about. Because definitely it's corrupting your system. It's going to cause a problem for catching another tune from the Quran and Hadith and all that. That's why the ulama said, no, we don't allow that virus come to our ears. That's why Nabi Muhammad put the, let's teach our children to have that entertainment from the Quran al-Kareem. We'll find a halal alternative for that. May Allah make it easy for all our brothers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you a proper entertainment and adjust your soul and your nafs and your body according to Kitab and Sunnah. Short break, we'll continue after that.
La ilaha illallah. لا إله إلا الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Brothers and sisters in Islam, welcome back to our program. Once again, we thank all our viewers from our neighboring country, Botswana, Lesotho, and all our African countries who are watching our program. Shukran jazilan, and we're waiting for more inquiry from you. And inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it easy for us to fulfill all the need of the brothers, inshallah. My friend sent for me a very interesting SMS. He wants me to talk about second wife and all that. I got plenty friends married more than one wife. And we sit and talk. And we know that is to marry a second wife is halal in Islam. I got four. And I did make a special program about that, but my friend also want to trouble me and want me to say something. To marry, alhamdulillah, is halal. But what is beyond married or after married? I got one friend married, and I tried to tell him that, did you fulfill the right of the first one? He said, no. He said, why are you bringing another problem? But I will never encourage those who cannot fulfill the haq of the woman to marry the second one. Besides, she's the first one, she's going to break his nose and he will face a big problem. He said, no, but it's a sunnah. He said, do not abuse the words, it's called sunnah. Because that sunnah, they call it haqqun yuradu bihi batil. Some truth, but you're targeting falsehood. Please do not abuse the sunnah. That's why the non-Muslim, they accuse us because of the problem. Normally people go for the second one and she's younger than the first one. And ask me, I got two uncles. My grandfather, we got plenty in our life. So try to fulfill the haq of the first one. When you fulfill the haq of the first one, first wife, she will tell you, go and marry the second one. But now you're unable to fulfill the right of the I quote for you that the husband are two type. The men are two type, married men. We got one man, it's called Baal. Baal is the man who is unable to fulfill the right of his wife. So now I ask my friend, are you Baal or Zawj? The Zawj, husband, proper husband, the one who fulfilled the haq of his. Now we can say you are a real man when you fulfill the haq. We check on Arabic dictionary about the word Baal. It's also husband, but they say Baal in the Arabic language, classic Arabic language, it says أَرْضٌ لَا يَسْقُطُ عَلَيْهَا الْمَطَرُ إِلَّا مَرَّةً فِي السَّنَةِ. Piece of land, only rain come to it once a year. So we imagine that your wife is a land or farm, only you are the rain, you come and fulfill the right of your wife once a year, which is a crime. It's a crime in un-Islamic. I checked again, the word is called Baal. He said, plant, but doesn't have any fruit or any benefit. You just find the grass there, the animal don't eat it, or there's no crops there. Or cloud has no water or no rain. I checked the Baal, husband, very far from his wife. Psychologically can't cooperate, and physically can't cooperate, very far from his wife, and his wife far from him. That one is a Baal. Another one, Baal, the man, cannot fulfill the right of his wife. Sexual right, financial right, and dini right, and all that. So I'm asking my friend now, which jama'at you are? Are you from Baal or Zawj? And every man must think about it. Baal and all men, but that one here, is unable to look after his wife. You know, he cannot. And because in Quran Kareem described an old man as a Baal. وَإِنْ إِمْرَاتٌ خَافَتْ مِنْ بَعْلِهَا نُشُوزًا أَوْ إِعْرَاضًا. So once he turn away from the wife, they call him Baal. That problem, the relationship between the husband and wife, it caused a lot of friction in the ummah, especially on that private relation. People, when we talk about this thing, they think that we are disrespect the talk and all that. No, it's really, it's very serious. And ask us, we got plenty things there about this the thing. Zawj, now we can say Zawj now. Zawj is the man who marry for the sake of Allah and live with his wife for the sake of Allah. Zawj is the man who always accompany his wife. There are many, especially in our tradition, they say, this man is holding the tail of his wife. They say, no. She got right, be with the wife. And ahadith are plenty. Look at Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with Aisha radiallahu anha. Zawj, a giver with no blame and no showing favor. Don't count how many favor he done to his wife. That is called husband. Continuously giving his wife in any time through the age of his wife on that marriage. Qawwam. Husband is qawwam. What is qawwam? Standing under the surface of his wife and his family. Ar-rijalu qawwam. You know qiyam? Qawm. Stand up. Stand up. And there's no problem at all for the husband when he serves his wife. Many of the men think that the wife is servant. No. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kana fi khidmati ahli. He was standing in the kitchen. He was a servant to his family and nothing wrong at all. We can carry the food to our family, not only our wives. Any women need help, we have to do like that. Ar-rijalu qawwamuna ala nisa. Entertain your wife. This lady cannot go and marry another man. You have exit to go, some way to marry another one. But this lady, she's a prisoner in your house. So Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ala bikrun tula'ibuha wa tula'ibuk. Very, it's ibadah. Zawj, it's called ighna. Make your wife self-sufficient. Has no need to her father, mother, friend. You are her main person in his life, in her life. That is called ighna. Harth, it means fruitful marriage. Ask yourself, I married this woman for 15 years. How much achievement? How many children we get? And how is our children all that? Beautiful soil, we get a beautiful plant and fruit and all that. Brother and sister in Islam, let's fulfill the right of our wife. Let's learn about that and do not abuse the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And my friend, I don't stand against that. You marry, but don't phone me and say, my wife, the second wife, and the fight, and I don't know what must I do. I must kill two of them or I divorce all of them. May Allah give you hidayah, inshallah. Say alhamdulillah, accept your taqdeer and carry on with the mother of the children is your nasib and your taqdeer, inshallah. Now our respected brother Abdurrahman from Cape Town, shukran jazilan for all your words and shukran for concern about the ummah. The ummah is really, we look here and there and we find Muslim nation under attack. Of course, because haqq, the truth, always under target is not. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when did he rest? Not only him, thousands of prophets. But I want to wake up the ummah from something it's called ghafla. What is ghafla? Heedlessness. People are unaware. There is something they took our mind out from our deen. We do our salah as a routine, something like with a remote control. Go work, read your salah, come like this. There's no ruh, there's no soul in our life. And my friend is sending for me also some, and he say, why people are changing? Because I don't know, the enemy of Islam want us to be a deformed Muslim. You know, the just bring Islam to the mosque and go. That ghafla, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did warn us from it, or about it. Ghafil, the heedless, who's the person is unaware, are two. One is jahil. He doesn't know, he doesn't want to know. When you advise him, you say, hey, I'm okay like this. Or one being corrupted, like many of us, because of the media, because of a lot of things. Now, how you know that you are ghafil or you are unaware? When you don't feel your ibadah. You read your salah and you understand that salat is imaduddin. Allah fix your problem with salah, but you don't feel anything. You go for hajj, you don't feel anything. You come with the same person. Oh, you try to make tawbah, but you're back to the same thing. There's no achievement. There's no progress in your life. Now make sure that you are ghafil. You have to find out. If you got kidney problem, if you have eye problem, you run to the specialist. What's wrong with us when we feel that we are ghafla? Okay, how you know that you are ghafla again? When you are waiting for the reward, but there's no action to get that reward, there's no amal. Jannatun tajri, but where's the price? Where's the price? That is called yarjus thawab bila amal. And you have no amal at all. Ghafil loves to make tawbah. Really, he's willing to make tawbah, but he never get it yet. What's wrong? He say, I admire to stop, but I can't. But wallahi al-azim, if the doctor tell you cigarette will kill you tomorrow, you will stop. So now we are ghafil, because we postpone tawbah, we delay tawbah. You see, still young, next year, let me do this, inshallah, like that. No, Sayyidina Umar said, watch out, it's a false hope. Do stop it now. Sahaba, they used to worship idols. You worship fire. But when Nabi Muhammad said, say la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, they said it and stop totally. And read about the life of the Sahaba. That's why we have to talk about that ghafla and heedlessness or that unaware till we come away again and we understand who we are. Short break will continue after that, inshallah.
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Brother and sister in Islam, welcome back to our program. Once again we thank you that you're watching our show, and once again we thank all our friends behind the camera there, and ask all our friends, Brother Farhad and Brother Mahmoud and all of Brother Bruiz and all our friends here on the studio, shukran jazilan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for all of them. And once again we thank all our friends for the emails and SMSs, and we continue with the request of the brother And as I said to all my viewers many times, I'm not a mufti, so you have to, especially divorce and all that inheritance story and all that, you can send SMS to it about it, because you need a mufti, a permanent mufti, not the normal one, so that you can sit personally and solve that problem, because it's huququl ibad. May Allah make it easy for us. Before the break, I was talking about the ghafla and heedlessness, and that person who got a false hope. And another sign of ghafla, that person got fear, but he didn't do any action to prevent himself from the fear. Like I'm scared that someone is gonna come and break my house, but I didn't close the door. So what that fear will work or help? We need to do some action to practice that fear to action. Another thing, kalamul muttaqin wa amalul munafiqin. Allah save us. Beautiful words. Cries, enjoy the bayan, but he cannot take out some sickness from his heart. It's called hypocrisy. Especially those alladhina hum yura'un, those who show off piety, those who are hypocrites in ibadah. You know, you are playing a very risky game with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know whom you're cheating? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that Allah prepare for them a punishment. Another sign of ghafla, hate to die, and also don't know how to live. He's trying, hate to die, and also can't live Islamically. So what are we going to do now? We lost dunya and akhirah. That is a sign of ghafla. Sign of ghafla, that you don't want to listen to advice. Someone remind you about your problem, you don't want to hear. Many of our brothers say, no, I don't like that sheikh who's going to shout me. There's one I don't want. Let me forget. You say, Muslim, don't forget. We solve the problem. We don't forget we got the problem. You have a friendship or company, someone who got the same ghafla like you. Try to justify his mushkila. People involved in drug, they become a friend. You say, what can we do? People involved in zina, like that. كُلٌّ عَلَى شَاكِلَتِ يَعْمَلُ عَلَى شَاكِلَتِ الطُّيُورُ عَلَى أَشْكَالِهَا تَقَعُ. So this type of relationship, it shows that ghafla. You are lazy for salah. Why you have a friendship and have a friend also lazy for salah? Why you don't try to get another one to get infected by him and he teach you something? You have shortage of knowledge. Why you don't get little bit alim so that you can increase your friend and your wife and all same. Another sign also, people based on dhan, they rely on doubt. But he doesn't want the certain things. Like any excess to run away from the fard, run. Like before I said, someone said, music halal, music makruh, haram, makruh. He said, let me take that one, the easy one. So why don't you go for the certain thing to be on safe side? And he said, alhamdulillah. The other thing also, they make false tawakkul. They call it tawakkul. Allah is the provider. Allah is ghafur rahim. He said, yes, but after you do something. He said, Allah is the provider. He said, okay, Allah give us sustenance and Allah provide us. Yeah, but did you plant? No, Allah is the provider. Say, no, your farm will never give you a single seed. Plant and say, Allah is the provider. You go for jihad, yeah, wa'addu lahum mastata. Your Nabi did do that. He got wahi with him, he got angel with him, but he did make a plan and use the means of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this man here, he just make false tawakkul. False tawakkul, it means you just rely on Allah with no action at all. Also ghafla, that he trusted his iman. The dangerous thing of your iman, when you feel that you have complete iman. Sahaba never have that feeling at all. They cry. And Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab run to the Sahaba and say, I ask you by Allah, did Rasulullah write my name with the hypocrites people? And Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq and plenty Sahaba, they say, no, we need it to Allah. We never done enough. So you are like that. Another thing also, he's counting his sin as a minor sin. We asked the sister, why are you not wearing the scarf? She said, no, it's heart. Sheikh Iman is here. Oh, no, people doing worse than mine. He said, no. But why you don't compare yourself with those who are doing better than you? For money, we run for that one. For sin, we run for that bottom one. No, no, that one. Competing for money, and you say he's collecting more than me. But for Salah, I said, no, I read my Salah, but no Fajr. But I got one friend, he don't read Salah at all. No, we have to be fair and compete with the top one, not with the lower one. Brother and sister in Islam, we always say, mind your heart. Do not fall under this type of ghafla and heedlessness, because our heart are three. Heart is empty heart, full of shaitan. And shaitan promised they're going to corrupt the heart. Once the heart corrupted, khalas. إذا صلح صلح الجسد كل وإذا فسد فسد. If you come right, the whole body will come right. Now that heart very difficult to maintain, to fix. Another type of heart, you got little bit of hope, nur of iman. That one year, inshallah, we got jihadun nafs, advising him, pushing him, inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will assist him, that we call him mujahid. Another heart, alhamdulillah, full of nur. Nur of a'mal. They call it nur of a'mal. Once you do the action, you burn the waswasa. You burn that shaitan. So burn that. That's why we call him a wali of Allah. Okay, I want to tell you something. What do you feel after you read Salatul Fajr when you come home? Full of nur. Why? Because you feel that you done something very special. When you come from Hajj, when you help someone, it's healing. So many of the people, they have that type of nur of a'mal, do action. Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when you see the person commit a sin, say, go and do some action, good deed. When you do some good deed, if it's rehabilitation, it's a healing, it's healing. So many people, they say, oh, I committed wrong, I done this, I say, you know what? Give the sadaqah, go give zakat, make hajj, make umrah, go to help people, try to pay back. So it's called rehabilitation. Another heart is called qalbul mutma'in. That heart is already settled in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That qulub, awliya'ullah, anbiya, and salihin. That is the heart which all of us we are targeting. Pass in any difficulties. Accept the taqdeer of Allah, giving like taking away from him. Funeral, same like wedding. Just nafsul mutma'inna. Ya ayyatuha nafsul mutma'inna. Irji'i ila rabbiki radiyatan mardiyya. Such a wonderful heart. We see it. And we still have people with us. Have that nafsul mutma'inna. As the nafs of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he said, ya Allah, do whatever you do to me, I will accept, because that is your desire. And we are trying, every Muslim must encourage one another to have that type of nur in the heart. Increase, because we have weakness. وَتَوَاسَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاسَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. We have to encourage. You are weak, your wife will build you up. Your friend, imam, sheikh, father, mother, we have to cooperate and bring us back to that time. If you work alone, you will be alone with shaitan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for all of us to have that type of nafsul mutma'inna. I like to thank Brother Hassan, and you know all my friends, do you know I got a permanent viewers and you got the new viewers. Now they ask about jinnat and all that. I don't know, I'm not a professional on that. I understand that some of African people and some of Asian people and Arabs and plenty, they never solved out that problem. What is jinnat? And my sister got jinnat, no one marry her, and my wife, she got jinnat, and we got plenty, but I don't want to advertise for that type of problem here on TV, because really it's an amazing topic and people like to know about it. But me, I don't like to talk about it, because Quran also give us a little bit of portion about it in Quran, little bit of information, and he left. Really, the sihr, does shaitan have power to change the taqdeer of Allah? All right, did Allah send jinnat to me
to do something and then Allah will punish me after that, after he sent, I become a mukrah, forced to do something. Does this woman responsible because she's fighting with her husband, is she sick or guilty? That man who feel that he got jinnat, what should he do? Right? Does people get jinnat for real? Or is imagination, or is shaitan? Always, we talk about this surah, Quran is called Surah Al-Jinn. We do have some problem with jinn. But what is jinn? Jinn is shaitan. Shaitan is the worst magic we have in our life. 24 hours someone behind us. So before you talk about a foreigner or outsider jinn, talk about your own shaitan. And many of our friends, they like their own shaitan because he inspired them for good stuff, haram. So you're listening to him, you got a nice relationship with his jinn, shaitan. But when we tell him you have jinn, he gets scared. But when you tell him you have shaitan, he says, yes, I have shaitan, my shaitan, my shaitan. But many people don't understand that shaitan is also jinnat, and jinnat is also shaitan, from the same tribe, same khalq. You think that the fight in Somalia, on Mali now, or in Iraq, or in Palestine, is done by jinnat and shaitan, or done by human being like me and you? Very strange question, and we need a lot of things to answer about that. May Allah make it easy for us. My cameraman asked me to stop for break. We'll continue after that.
La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brother and sister in Islam, welcome back to our program. Once again, we thank all our friends for inquiry and queue and all the questions. And shukran jazilan. I'd like to thank Brother Faisal and his family and all our viewers from Roshni and Iyer and Pretoria and Lodium. And shukran jazilan for all our viewers for the comment, and we'll wait inshallah for more inquiry. May Allah make it easy for us inshallah. Before the break, my friend was asking about the jinnat and all that unseen creation of Allah. I said before, we do believe this jinnat, but the problem, who's going to decide that you have jinnat? And who from us has no jinnat? When I say jinnat, it means shaitan. So jinn is a kafir, the shaitan is a kafir of the jinn, al-kafiru min al-jinn. So which human being will decide and discover that you have jinn, right? If you have jinn, is it because of you, or Allah sent it to you, or someone else sent it to you? And why that jinn came to you and did not come to someone else? And who is there who got that power to control the taqdeer of Allah and take life of someone, and give life and give luck to someone and take it? That is a very serious discussion, and the ulama must come and talk and teach us how to set up that problem in the mind of the people. Because plenty of people, they become dajjal, they cheat us, they make money out of that and all that. Right? Someone know how to take out jinnat. Right? How? He must teach us, he mustn't keep it secret. Because Quran al-Kareem, we say, قُلْ أَعُوذُ رَبِّ النَّاسِ مَلِكِ النَّاسِ. So we seek protection in Allah from مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ. So it's by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, many of our brothers say, okay, I got it from Allah. So you must teach the ummah. Right. You got two types of infection of the jinnat, as the ulama said. One, because we are weak. A weak body get virus quickly. If you don't have a proper cover, light clothes in the winter, you get flu and fever and cold and all that. If your system of your body is weak, when you eat food, you like this. So sometimes you are weak. When we say weak, you are not under the care of Allah. Illa ibadaka minhum al-mukhlasin. Shaitan said, I will leave those you want them. So why don't you be from ibadaka al-mukhlasin? From the slave, which pure slave, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And very easy to be from this group. Right. The lady came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, Ya Rasulullah, inni usra. I fit. I collapse on the street. So the
He didn't tell her jinnat and all that. He said, make sabr, be patient. So the first medication, if you feel that you have jinnat, maybe because of us, we brought the viruses, which is shaitan, so you make sabr. That is only way we make sabr. Number two, sta'id billah, seek protection in Allah. Read the Quran, try to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because enemy like any enemy, we make dua to Allah protect our house, Allah protect our children, we make dua before we drive, dua before we eat. So there is a dua also before we get infected by that shaitan. I'm going to name it as a shaitan now, not jinnat. The other thing also, dhikrullah. That forgotten ibadah, many Muslims, they don't know how to make dhikrullah. Sometimes they make bid'ah dhikr, and they don't know how to praise Allah. And once you make dhikrullah, jinnat will go away. The only strong weapons to get out shaitan from is dhikr. Ala bi dhikrillahi tatma'innu al-qulub. When you make dhikrullah, shaitan go away. The other thing also, as there is also some prophetic medicine, 7 dates from Medina, Zamzam, black seed. We do it as a means. Dua of the pious people, ruqya, honey, ayatul kursi, the verse of kursi, ending of Surah Al-Baqarah, and also the first portion of Surah Hamim, ghafir, till ilayhi al-masir, and we have knowledge, learn. Because the alim is more powerful against shaitan and jinn more than the worshipper. Because we know how to deal with the jinnat and all that to ourselves. The other thing also, let your parents make dua. May Allah protect you from jinnat and nas. Let your parents, because that dua is accepted. Sleep on wudu, walk on wudu. Nothing wrong will happen to you. And do not go to the witchcraft and future teller and all these people. Because you go there, they're going to give you more jinnat. They heal one portion and give you another. Never ever see a person went to them and come right. You're going to get again and again. And I got plenty example there. Never, never. كذب المنجمون والأوصى. Even if he tell you the truth. And also, it's haram. Okay. Haram, so don't eat haram. Don't take haram to get healed. Okay, you have a stomach problem. And doctors tell you, you drink alcohol, beer, your stomach will come right. You think that is permissible to eat, to do like that? لا تداوي من حرام. You think that is halal like this? We have to follow the Kitab and Sunnah, because it is a serious issue and corrupting your iman. May Allah make it easy, inshallah. I'd like to thank our respected brother from Durban, waking up for Salatul Fajr. You read this dua, inshallah. All of us, we experience that. Dua of Aisha. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught Aisha radiallahu anha, you read the last portion of Surah Al-Kahf first, and then the last ayah of Surah Al-Kahf, and then you read this dua. Allahumma, that dua, you read it before you sleep, 3 times. Allahumma, la tu'amminni makrak. Aisha radiallahu anha told the Sahaba how to wake up for Salatul Fajr, which is all of us, we need it. Allahumma, la tu'amminni makrak, that dua. Wa la takshif anni sitrak. Wa la tunsini dhikrak. Wa la tuwallini ghayrak. Wa la taj'alni minal ghafilin. That is dua. You read it 3 times. The 4th time you say, oh angels, wake me on that time. The angel, inshallah, you will have some reason to wake up. Your son will wake you up. Someone will knock, phone will ring. You'll roll on bed. You will find something. You have a dream or something. You will wake up if you have yaqeen in this dua. I'm going to repeat the dua full, and then our brother can write behind us. اللهم لا تؤمني مكرك ولا تكشف عني سترك ولا تنسني ذكرك ولا تولني غيرك ولا تجعلني من الغافلين. Many of our brothers are going to ask, repeat again. I'm going to read one by one. because they're going to send SMS. I have to send them to in Arabic. Allahumma la tu'amminni makrak wa la takshif anni sitrak wa la tunsini thikrak wa la tuwallini غيرك ولا تجعلني من الغافلين. That is a dua narrated by Aisha رضي الله عنها that Nabi Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم taught her and she taught the ummah, and we have to believe on this dua. So inshallah very easy, and you read Salatul Fajr, you under the safety of Allah till you return back. Brother and sister in Islam, let us enjoy our life according to Kitab and Sunnah, and let us believe in the Quran and the Hadith of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah subhanahu wa taala reward all our brothers and sisters. I got one quick request because I see my time is running. Nasara, the Christian, and I don't know if we have enough time to reply to this one. They say they're worshiping Allah. Well, they enter Jannah or Jahannam. We said, you know what? The issue of Jannah and Jahannam is not in my hand. يغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء. He will forgive whom he wants and he will punish whom he wants. So that one, we don't interfere, because the wish of Allah, the will of Allah is in his hand. But I want to tell my viewers, because my friend has said, she's a very good lady, she's helping us, she's worshipping God, she's very honest, doesn't drink, doesn't lie and all that. He say, you know what? You put me on a very difficult situation now to tell you. Quran al-Kareem finalized that debate. فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ فَقَدْ اهْتَدَوْا. If they believe exactly like the way you believe, now they have hidayah, they have guidance. Their God are three. Ours is Wahidun Ahad. You don't believe in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Our deen based on the belief of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Our salah is not like the salah. Mithl, typical, exactly the same. So now get for me any people of the book. One of the people of the book, they believe in La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Give me one like that. I'm not talking about those who are fighting Islam. I'm talking about the peaceful one, those who see. Our children's name are Jesus, Isa, and Musa, and Ibrahim, and Yunus. But their children's names never be Muhammad. So where's the similarity? Where's the equality between us and them? In morality and all the akhlaq, manners, okay, Anbiya, they came because it's natural. Respect your mother, respect you for like that. But aqaid, my friend, thought, belief, the faith, la ilaha illallah, there's none worthy of worship besides Allah. Lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yakul lahu kufan, none comparable to him. So who's Jesus to you and who's Jesus to them? We do respect the faith of the other, but I want to remind myself and all our viewers, there's a lot of difference. And then Allah is a judge. Right? We give da'wah, we try to explain. And Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in his lifetime, there was a Christian and Jew. That's why we said to the brother and sister in Islam, you got rules, you got certain relationship between us and people of the book. Islam give us rules how to deal with them. But in ibadah, we are Muslimin. We are the follower of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Jesus is a messenger of Allah. Allah has no children. Allah has no one comparable to him. He's the one and only. We do believe in the oneness of Allah and the unity of God. That is our main belief. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. We love Jesus Christ as a messenger of Allah, as the word of Allah. But Allah is the creator of this universe. Is Almighty God, not Jesus Christ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide all people to Hidayah. May Allah make it easy for us to fulfill the right of Allah and His Messenger, inshallah. Unfortunately, our time is up. We'll continue next time, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب سوى
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله لا إله إلا الله